This video will give an overview of the automatic target lock feature that is found in robotic total stations and multi-stations. The video focuses on Viva and Nova total stations and multi-stations that are powered by Leica Captivate. Automatic target lock means the instruments can automatically follow the target when it moves. This is known as being locked, as the crosshairs are locked to the target. Combined with continuous distance measurement, the position of the target can be continuously tracked, which allows rapid measurements to be made without the need to keep manually aiming at the target. Automatic target lock means the instruments can be operated remotely. There is no need for a second person to operate the instrument, meaning there are no delays with finding the target, aiming, measuring and communicating, and you are in complete control of the data collection and quality. It works with any standard reflective prism, meaning there is no need to use a specially designed target which requires batteries and increases weight on the pole. Automatic target lock works by using ATR Plus, which is found in all robotic total stations powered by Leica Captivate. ATR stands for Automatic Target Recognition, and the Plus stands for the improved performance found in the latest generation self-learning instruments. ATR Plus uses an image sensor within the telescope to detect a reflective target. Whenever the target moves, the image sensor detects the movement and, together with the motors, adjusts the instrument to keep it pointing at the target, therefore remaining locked. Because the instrument is self-learning, it constantly adjusts to the environmental conditions to maximize the lock performance. The CMOS image sensor detects the target as a light spot. The laser energy is constantly adjusting according to the conditions. ATR Plus also continuously analyzes the motion of the follow target and ignores any other targets or foreign reflections to make sure that it stays locked to the correct target. To use lock, the instrument must be put into lock mode. This can be set in the measure and target panel. Let's look at the various ways of searching and aiming at the target in order to get locked. A quick way to switch into lock mode and get locked in one button press is to use one of the lock buttons in the aim and search bubble. Pressing search and lock will perform a fine search, which should be used when the instrument is already roughly pointing towards a target. Once the target is found, the instrument will lock to it. Another option is wait and lock. Pressing the wait and lock button will perform a static search, which means the instrument does not move. It should be used when the target is already within the field of view of the telescope. When the target is found, the instrument will lock to it. If there is no target in the field of view, the instrument will remain actively waiting for one to appear. When it does, the instrument will lock to it. Next, we have power search. Pressing one of the power search buttons in the aim and search bubble will perform a rapid 360-degree search for the target, quickly locating it in any direction. Power search can be used to gain lock when the instrument is already in lock mode. Once the target is found, the instrument will lock to it. Note that having pressed one of the search and lock, wait and lock, or power search bubble buttons to find and lock to the target, that a distance will not be taken. Distance or measure must be pressed in addition in order to make a single measurement or to start continuous distance measurements. Pressing distance or measure is another way to gain lock when the instrument is already in lock mode and the instrument is roughly pointing towards the target. Fine search will be performed, and once the target is found, a distance will be measured and the target then remains locked. If continuous distance measurement is also active, the instrument will continuously measure, meaning the target is being tracked. Once locked, the instrument will continue to follow the target as it moves around. Because the target is continuously followed, making measurements is extremely quick. If the distance is also being continuously measured, then points can be stored almost instantly, meaning a significant gain in productivity. When it is wanted to temporarily unlock from the target, For example, if the target needs to be placed down somewhere, the target lock off button can be used in the aim and search bubble. Then to get relocked, use one of the options already discussed. When the instrument is locked to the target and the line of sight to the target is interrupted, the instrument will switch into prediction mode. If the interruption is short, the prediction enables the instrument to quickly regain lock of the target. For example, when the target passes behind a tree or a vehicle passes in front of the target, there is a minimum interruption to lock, and the user may not even notice that prediction was used. The prediction uses the motion of the target to predict where it will become visible again. The target prediction time limit can be changed in the target search settings panel. If the instrument is not able to get relocked to the target within the prediction time limit, an automated search will be started. The type of search can be set in the target search settings panel, so let's have a look at each one. When wait and lock is chosen, after prediction ends, the instrument will stop moving and wait for the targets to appear again within the field of view of the telescope. The instrument will remain waiting, relocking to the target once it appears within the view. When find search is chosen, after prediction ends, the instrument will perform a spiral search. The extent of this search is determined by the position of where the target was last seen. Once the target is found, the instrument will relock to it. When cube search is chosen, after prediction, it will perform a kind of power search within a cube. The instrument will turn back 45 degrees from the last known target position. It will then search in 90 degrees until the target is found and it can get relocked. If the distance of the last known position is available, the search will also be refined to a range of plus and minus 10 meters from that position. Note that in these cases where the instrument automatically gets itself relocked to the target, if a continuous distance was being measured before, it will be automatically restarted again. The final option is turn to last measured point. When this is chosen, after prediction, the instrument will automatically turn and point towards the last recorded point. A message will appear waiting for the user to position the target on this point. Pressing OK will then perform a find search to get the target relocked again. This video gave an overview of automatic target lock, which is a feature of robotic total stations and multi-stations. Other videos will look into other robotic total station features, so do watch those videos if you would like to learn even more. Thanks for watching.